What is going on, guys? This is your dude Shop, and in today's video, we're going to talk about AI and Canva in particular. Canva has a bunch of AI tools that will help you be more efficient and more effective in your content creation. I can't wait to show you the things that I found out and some of the things that I know you can use right away. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, before we get started, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to the channel. Also hit that notification bell so you don't miss any more of these videos that I'm going to be doing to help you streamline your content creation. For those who might not know, Canva is an easy to use online design platform that allows you to create professional quality graphics, presentations, and more. One of the best things about Canva is its built-in AI tools that can help elevate your design and streamline your creative process. So let's explore some of these AI features. First up is Canva's AI Background Remover that allows you to remove the background of any photo or image. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna select the YouTube thumbnail, and then we're gonna go ahead and go to our uploads, and we're gonna go ahead and upload a picture of my created golfer on PGA Tour. Once it's loaded, we're just gonna click him, and we wanna just get him without all of this extra background. So what you wanna do is make sure you select the image, go to Edit Photo, and go to Background Remover. Now you'll notice that Background Remover is for pro version. You can get a free trial of the pro version. I think it's a great investment if you are a content creator to sign up for Canva Pro. It has a lot of abilities. We'll get into that in another video, but do it, just do it. Now a lot of the other things that I'm gonna show you later on in this video will not require Canva Pro at all, but I do think this is a great tool that saves me a lot of time, so I use it. So just click Background Remover, and after a few seconds, you'll get a clean image of just what you want, and you can resize it to however you want it. You can, you know, click the background and change the color, and boom, there you go. And this will be a great thing, especially when you're trying to create thumbnails for your YouTube videos. All right, let's get into the next piece. All right, next we're gonna talk about Canva's AI color palette generator. And if you've ever struggled with, when you're creating an image or a thumbnail, finding the right colors to add to complement the other images on your screen, this is the tool for you. So we're gonna go over here to elements, and we're just gonna pick this triangle, and we're gonna sort of increase this triangle and kind of put it like this, sort of like a extra panel over here. Now, of course, this red does not look good, right? So what we can do is we can go to the color, and we're trying to find a color, but as you can see right here, Canva gives you the color palette of images you already have on here. So I already have this image that we used earlier with the background remover, and it gives me a nice color palette. So I can choose one of these colors, and actually that looks good right there. That's actually a good blend and can be something good. So use this if you're ever struggling with colors. It has helped me out a lot to figure out what colors go with what picture. And as you can see here, the color palette is a great tool. So let's go on to the third AI tool for Canva. All right, next up is Canva's Magic Write feature. Writing engaging and persuasive text for your designs, whether it's Instagram post or Twitter post or Instagram reels or stories, can be challenging. But that's where Magic Write comes in. This AI-powered tool can help you generate compelling text for your design based on a few simple steps. And I'm gonna show you a way to kind of automate your social post, whether you're posting on Twitter, Instagram, Instagram stories, Facebook Reels, or whatever. I'm gonna show you a nice little automation process that you can use right out the box. You don't need Canva Pro or anything. So let's go ahead and get into it. All right, in order to use Magic Write in Canva, you do have to open up a doc. So we're gonna open up a doc. And once you do, you'll be presented with this. And what you wanna do now is go ahead and click the plus sign so you can go to Magic Write click magic, right? And then what you want to do is you want to say, give me 10 mode. Let's say you're a fitness person and you want to put out fitness motivation quotes every day for the next 10 days on Instagram. So we're going to say, give me 10 fitness motivational quotes, and let's say, and add hashtag shop fit to the end of them. So maybe your thing is, hey, I want, that's my hashtag, that's what I want, shop fit. And also let's add emoji to it too. So give me 10 fitness motivational quotes with at least one emoji and add shop fit to them. So let's go ahead and enter. All right, so here we have our 10 motivational quotes, fitness motivational quotes. Sweat now, shine later. Don't stop when you're tired, stop when you're done. Hashtag shop fit. These all look good. Your body can stand almost anything. It's your mind that you have to convince. Hashtag shop fit. And you can go ahead and, you know, add or delete any of these. We kind of like them, so we're gonna go ahead and copy all of them right now. Then we're gonna go to our spreadsheet and we're gonna paste in those motivational quotes. All right, so here we have those motivational quotes in our spreadsheet. All right, let's go back to Canva and let's go back to home. And now let's say, okay, we want to create social media posts, right? We want to create Instagram posts. So let's go here and it has Instagram posts right here. Or you can just type in up here, Instagram post. And you can do the square or the portrait. We're going to do the square. Now, once you do the square, it's going to find you a whole bunch of templates. And through the templates, you can put in quotes to get all the templates that have good quotes. So we're looking at these and which one looks promising? You know what? I kind of like it simple. So let's go with, I want you something simple. Let's go with this. Let's go with this right here. All right. So let's go to customize this template. And here we have the quote, we have this, we have a name and a website. So let's say you want to put your website right here. So we'll just put shopmastertv.com, which is my website. We'll get rid of this and we'll just leave the quote right here. All right. So how do we get this to display those quotes that we had? All right. So what we want to do is we want to go to apps and we want to go to bulk create. Now you have the option to upload a CSV or you have an option to enter data manually. We're just going to enter it manually. We're going to go ahead and move this. We're going to go ahead and clear the table and we're going to paste our quotes right here. So here we have our quotes and then we're going to put title or quote. We'll just put quote. All right. So now that you have that, you can go ahead and click done. And then right here, we want to, this is how you connect it. You connect data to the quote. And now it's saying that, okay, we've connected your data and now you can continue. It says one data. All right. So it looks like I need to, let's go back. Well, hold on. Let's continue. All right. So now it gives me all of the quotes that I had. And now all you have to do is click generate the 10 quotes, the 10 pages. And it goes in and it adds all the 10 pages or all the 10 quotes to these pages. And you can go in here, of course, and modify it, of course, you know, make things bigger. But this saves you a lot of time, you know, instead of having to create all of that, you didn't have to think about the quotes. You didn't have to really put them in by themselves. You can adjust the, you know, the font. You can adjust the font type and everything. So there you have it. That is Magic Write with some AI process, using it to, one, give you the quotes that you need or give you whatever you're looking for. Maybe you're just looking for a title, it'll give you a title as well. And then an automated process to put those into a table and then put them on these pages, which you can then download and upload to your social media. So you can upload this straight to Instagram, as you can connect your Instagram to your Canva, and boom, it's that simple. All right, let's go into the final and last thing we're going to talk about with AI in Canva. All right, finally, we have come to Canva's text to image feature. With this AI tool, you can transform simple text into visually striking images. And if you've seen any of the stuff that I've posted on Twitter, I have posted where I'm using Midjourney to create some very quality images just from text prompting. And this does the same thing, except it's inside Canva's own tool. So that will help you create maybe thumbnails that you are trying to figure out. Maybe there's a specific image that you want, but of course you're not an artist, so you don't know how to draw it. Well, creating a text prompt and then allowing this AI to create an image can be very beneficial and effective. So let's go ahead and jump into it. All right, finally, we've come to Canva's AI text to image tool, and we're going to use the same kind of thumbnail that we were working with before, and we're going to go to apps, and then we're going to go to text to image. Now, I will say that I feel like this is pretty new to Canva, and so it may not be as good as a Midjourney, but as in everything with AI, prompts are very important. And so you put in your prompt here for whatever you want. And it says include objects, colors, locations, surroundings, people. Here are some of the styles, none. And you have, you know, retro, photo, watercolor. And then you have aspect ratio. Now, me, I'm trying to create this thumbnail. And let's say I just want a red golf ball. So I just put in red golf ball, you know, because I use a red golf ball with my created player. So let's go ahead. We're not going to choose any particular style. And let's see what we get. Now, it's going to create four images for you. Some are going to be crazy looking, but if you start to play around with it, you'll learn sort of what things you need to come off. And this looks amazing. So this looks great. This looks great. Even I would say even this looks really good, but it doesn't show the whole golf ball. So we're just gonna, I really like this one. This one's pretty good too, but it's something about this one. So we're going to just use this one. And again, you can use this for whatever. So play around with it. It says even down here, we're evolving this new technology. So if there are any issues, please report them. But if you've used any of AI's kind of text to imaging tools, you'll know that sometimes the images don't all come out right. This is actually not a bad picture also, but it's not a red golf ball. I don't even know if that's a golf ball at all, but we got our red golf ball, and so we can put that anywhere. Maybe we can edit it so we can remove the background and just get the red ball. Let's see if that works. And we do. So we can just use this red golf ball just for whatever we want to do with it, wherever we want to place it. So there it is. That is the text to image tool. Again, like I said, play around with it, see what you like, see what you don't like about it. But obviously it can create images for you without having you know exactly how to draw or be an artist, because I'm useless in that area, but I digress. All right, and that's it. These are just a few examples of how Canva's AI tools can help you create stunning images and generate new ideas for your content, and it allows you to be more efficient. I really enjoyed the bulk creation of the Instagram post. I hope that maybe you can use it. I've been using it for a lot of my Twitter content. But if you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and also share it with your fellow content creators. Also, don't forget to hit stick that like button, subscribe to the channel for more tips and tricks on how AI can boost your content creation game. Until next time, thanks for watching. If you want to learn more about AI tools and how they can help, I have some other videos coming up. Appreciate y'all. This should do shop. I'm out. Peace.